What's happening? Welcome to a little bonus video here in the Making Mead at Home series. Today I'm going to do something a little different. I've got some maple syrup. So I'm going to make a small batch of this, I don't know what you call it, maple mead. It's not really the same as mead because mead's only made with honey. So I'm not sure what you'd call it, but I'm going to make a little 2 gallon batch. Got my Mr. Beer 2 gallon fermenter here that I'm gonna make it in. Just getting it sanitized right now. Yeah, I'm basically just gonna throw together some maple syrup, some water, and some yeast, and see what comes of it. I tried it once before, a smaller batch, but it didn't really come out too good. I didn't have enough syrup, I don't think. So we'll give it another try, see what happens. Could be pretty good. The syrup was a little crystallized, so I'm doing the same thing as I do with my mead when the honey's, when I need to warm up the honey, I'm just soaking it in some hot water here. Alright, so what I'm going to be doing here is basically just doing equal parts syrup and water. Like I said last time, I tried this. I think I had not enough syrup, so I'm just going to do the same amount of syrup as I do water and see how that comes out. I'm just going to throw the stuff together, syrup, water, and yeast, and see what comes of it. Could be something nice. I'm just going to use the same jug that the syrup came out of to put the water into. A little bit too much water, maybe. Okay, just go ahead and use this to measure out the water. Why not? Some pure Ohio maple syrup. That's the good stuff right there. Shake that up, get the last little bit of syrup out of there. Dump that right on in there too. This one's not full completely. So I'm gonna maybe a quarter of the way full. I'll go ahead and dump that in and alright, so I got this one opened up, and there was some kind of funky looking, possibly mold or something in it. Possibly mold in there. I don't know, so I'm not going to use it. I don't know what the heck it is. So basically what I've got here is a quart of maple syrup and a quart of water. In there. Now, just shake that up a little bit, get the yeast all mixed up in there. Yeah, I'm not really sure how this is going to come out. I was hoping to get more syrup in there. But with that one bottle being possibly bad, I don't want to risk it. Here's the thing though, I'm going to check the gravity. See where it's at. If it's more than the last time I made it, starting out, then it might be alright. Okay, that's not even sinking at all. And you can see that it's not even getting down to the line where I can measure. Thanks for watching this sort of bonus little video in my Making Mead at Home Season 2. I don't really know. I was hoping for more syrup than that, but I'm going to just let it ride and see what comes out, see what comes of it. It's got to be pretty high in sugar. I couldn't even measure the original gravity. The hydrometer was just floating, it wouldn't even give me a measure, so who knows? Maybe onto something here with the maple mead. But if that's the case, then I'm gonna need to start getting bigger amounts of syrup and doing bigger batches of that, but that's a problem for future Jake. So, anyways, if you enjoyed, be sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel.
Oh, it's a floof dog.